No, I got a good one. So a woolly mammoth, a dodo bird, and a saber-toothed tiger walk into a bar. No, sorry, hang on. Let me start over, that's not how it goes. It starts out like this. Three friends go exploring. They travel for 75 meters at 1.2 meters per second until they realize they all need to pee. They stop, they pee, it takes a minute, and they continue at a little faster speed, 1.5 meters per second, for 33 seconds. The question is, what's their average velocity? Or what's their average speed? So here's the problem written out. They are going 75 meters at a certain speed. They stop for 1.0 minutes and they continue at 1.5 meters per second for 33 seconds. We need to make a table in order to do this problem. So I'm gonna make a table that lists distances and times and speeds. And my distances are going to be in units of meters, of course, times in units of seconds. Interesting. And speeds will be in units of meters per second. And I'm gonna fill in what I know from this right here. I guess I could use colors to underline each thing as I go. Let me say first that I'm gonna have a first phase and a second phase and a third phase. So these are phases of the friendly journey. And then we're probably going to have a total phase right here, or let's call it a total phase. So first I'll fill in this information right here, 75 meters at 1.2 meters per second. So phase one is 75 meters and the speed is 1.2 meters per second. And phase two we'll do in gray because it's very boring, peeing for 1.0 minutes. We gotta convert minutes into seconds and I know that 1.0 minutes can be multiplied by one like this. I say, 1 minute is the same thing as 60 seconds. Well, I mean, I'm really making this overly complicated here. I'm gonna put 1 minute in the denominator and 60 seconds in the numerator and find that this is going to be equal to 60 seconds. Look at that, boy, was that complicated. And I put that in phase two for a 60 second run right there. And then let's do blue for the final phase, a greater speed and a shorter time. So the speed here is 1.5 meters per second and the time, oh, we don't even know the distance for that one. The time is 33 seconds. Let us put a line under here so I don't get my totals mixed up. And I'm now gonna try to fill in all of these blanks. The first one that I see is that we should have a zero distance during the peeing time. You don't walk and pee. That's just one of the things. And then speeds, well, your speed is zero if the distance, zero, divided by the time, 60, is our speed. Let's write down an equation for speed. I know that average velocity is change in position divided by change in time. So if I need to find any more speeds, I'll be able to do that. I guess that's our goal. In the end, we'll use this equation. But in the meantime, let's say we want to solve it for delta x so that we can do this problem right here. I would multiply both sides by delta t, wouldn't you? Sure, let's multiply by delta t, multiply by delta t. I switch these around because television is really distracting. And I say average velocity times time is how far you've gone. Try that out, grab a calculator. I wanna take the average velocity, which is 1.5 meters per second, and multiply it by the time, 33 seconds, and we find that we've gone 49.5 meters. I plug that sucker in right here. Should I use a new color? You want me to use like pink for the new data that we're plugging in? This is going to be 49.5 meters during that brisk trip after peeing. You know, you feel refreshed, right? So then let's take this equation and solve it for delta t. Of course, if we were back here solving for delta t, we would probably just, oh man, that'd be a mess. Well, we'd want to be careful. In fact, I think this would be our first step, but I want delta t on its own, so I'm going to divide by the average on both sides. No problem. And my equation now says, look at those guys canceling out right there. It says that the time a trip has taken is how far you've gone divided by how fast you were going. I hope you find that reasonable. And I'm gonna plug those in pink. I'm going to take the distance that we've traveled, 75 meters, and divide it by the speed, 1.2 meters per second. We get 62.5 seconds. Now, I'm not gonna do any significant figures here because I'm far from the end of my problem. I'll do all of these, I'll just carry them out as far as they go, within reason, and then I'll do the calculations and round at the very end. So I'm interested in using this initial equation here. We said V average is delta x over delta t. But if I want to know the average speed for the whole trip, I need the entire distance traveled and the entire time it took. To do that, I'll add up the distances. 75 plus 49.5, and that gives me, wait a second, what color should we use here? Purple. 124.5 meters, and the total time will be 60 plus 33 plus 62.5. That's 155.5. And I don't add up the speeds because that doesn't mean anything. I'm interested in the total distance traveled and the total time that it took. So I'll divide those suckers in order to find the total. Maybe I should call it the overall average velocity, 124.5 divided by 155.5. And that gives me, whoa, what luck. I say that the average velocity, overall average velocity, is 0.80 meters per second, which is very interesting. Because if I simply add up these three speeds and divide by three, I will not find the same average. Let's try that. 1.2, oh, let's open some parentheses, right? Go crazy. 1.2 plus 0 plus 1.5. I did that just for you. I added that zero in there just for you. And now I'm supposed to divide that sucker by three. Sorry, I should have done it one step. This, if I were taking a brutal sort of arithmetic mean kind of average, I would get 0.9. But the true overall velocity is 0.8. Why? That's your problem. Why? Here they are. They're going back now. Going back home. They're gonna go eat something. I wonder what they could agree on.